Welcome to Life Happened, the place where people send in their very personal life stories for us to share with you. You can make a huge difference in their lives by sharing your feelings and advice for them in the comments below. My name is Stella, your host, and this story is from Leo. Dear Stella, my name is Leo, and I grew up in South Florida as an African American man. As you can imagine, I have heard just as many racial slurs as any minority would in the South. A lot of people get the idea that all Florida is like Miami or Orlando. In reality, Florida is very much a part of the Deep South. It didn't help that my father had a close friend of his that was open about being with the Ku Klux Klan. My father and this close friend of his worked at a repair center. In the backwoods area that we lived in, you could make a lot of money fixing up assorted things like TVs and old computers. Stuff that most people would have to head to the city to get fixed. The day they met one another was when they had to share a vehicle to repair an old man's TV that went out. Driving together, the man was giving my father trouble about being black. Racial slurs and that sort of thing ensued. He had expected my dad to take it poorly or get rowdy. Instead, my father started to banter with him, returning the same amount of heat that he was getting. Note, racial slurs of any kind are very disturbing to sane people. The two of them got along so well that they got that TV fixed in about an hour, which was unusual considering how difficult it was to get the parts. By the end of their shift, the man invites my father out for a drink. My father, knowing the area well enough, knew that this bar was known for being a hangout for men that absolutely despised black men. Being the kind of man my father was, he didn't let this stop him from going. The man came clean with my father as they sat down for their drinks. He's a lower-ranking member of the Ku Klux Klan. Note, it's not every day that one finds himself in the presence of the KKK. That must have been very difficult for Leo's father. This story seemed like something out of a movie to me. It was absolutely insane to me that something like this would happen. Growing up, I didn't believe it until my father told me himself. Knowing that this white man who constantly complained about colored people, as he put it, would be close with my father, it was strange. He made sure to let my father, my mother, and me know that he had always viewed dark-skinned people as inferior. Note, how sad this was the case. This brings to mind a book we have listed in the description box below, which deals with this subject. And now would be a good time to hit the like button. So back to our story. The two of them spent a lot of time together. They were inseparable. During and after work, they were always spending a lot of time with each other. I was a little boy when they spent all this time together. They went hunting, shot pool, smoked, and drank. Always with this man was his constant complaining about black people. Even in public, he would use slurs. This was in the late 90s, and yet no one batted an eye when he flung the N-word around my mother and father. As time went on, the people of the bar that they went to began to become upset. As a place for white supremacists to drink and be away from minorities, the last thing they wanted to see was my father there. Racial slurs flew, and tensions eventually came to a head. It was only a matter of time before the bar-goers decided to fight for what they wanted. My father and his friend brawled with a group of other men that wanted them to leave. It was incredibly violent and ended with a few hospital visits. After that, they never went back to the bar. They started frequenting a different place and began to form a different group of friends. Funny though, the people that started the fight in the first place hated my father's friend more than they hated my father, simply because he's the one that invited him to drink there. Note, it is a good thing that your father and his friend left that bar. With alcohol involved, any type of arguing can take place, if the hatred was that bad, and who knows where else it could have led to. My father died nearly a decade ago now. Sadly, the man never made another minority his friend. Despite being friends for over 10 years, he still couldn't let go of his racist and bigoted ideas of what minorities were like. It really wasn't like as I once thought. For whatever reason, I thought that the experience that he had with my father would magically change all of his bogged up preconceptions. Sadly, this wasn't reality. Note, your father's friend probably grew up in a home where this was the norm. My dad's friend had a rough life for a long, long while after the dispute. His entire family pushed him away for siding with a black man over the KKK, and yet he still hated most minorities. Note, some people never change. Incredibly depressed, his brother was the only one of his relatives that took his side in the whole affair. Recently, his brother passed away, leaving him alone and hated by people that are supposed to be his family. I've always felt conflicted about the whole situation. I wonder if I should ever make contact with this man again. The little I remember about him was how often he threw racial slurs around my father. My dad didn't care, and neither did my mother. But I can't help but feel as though they let him walk all over the two of them because of the color of their skin. I sometimes check his social media. Every now and then he posts something about a promotion, a birthday, etc. As I said, I had hoped that he would have realized his beliefs were flawed. But just recently he posted something about his cousin being promoted in the KKK. Should I attempt to reconnect with him? I don't know if I could take a man in his 50s or 60s, talking about how much he hates my race all the while, telling stories and singing the praises of my father, a black man. Should I pity him because he gave up his family and the KKK for my dad? Or is he just another racist, not worth fretting over? Leo, thank you for sharing your story with us. It was quite interesting how your father befriended someone who was a racist. Now, I will give you my thoughts and opinions as to Leo's story, but I am not a relationship expert. However, I've lived life and know that any kind of prejudice, racial slurs, and bigotry are not part of a healthy society. In fact, these things don't belong in any society. But sadly, there will always be those people who think, believe, and act as the friend of Leo's father did. It is very sad that racism is apparent in our lives, and it comes in many different forms. We must all be careful what we say around people who are different from us. We must have understanding and compassion so as not to hurt those around us. Most likely, this is the way this man was raised. But even though he grew up around such behavior, he was old enough to realize that racism is not taken lightly and is ethically and morally wrong. Thankfully, in the United States, the KKK's numbers have dropped significantly, and there are approximately 3,000 to 8,000 such members in the country. These numbers come from the Anti-Defamation League report and the Southern Poverty Law Center. I won't delve more into this side of the story, but I do recommend a book which is mentioned in the description box below for more information. I'd like to comment on Leo's father and his unique friendship with someone who was clearly a prejudiced man. Why would Leo's father be a friend to this man? Well, perhaps Leo's father overlooked the racial slurs and bigotry because he was of an older generation. Sadly, perhaps he just expected it and thought there wasn't anything he could do about his friend's behavior. Back in the day, history shows us that there was great racial divide and that people of color were treated in a bad, inhumane way. But I am hoping that Leo's father was able to educate his friend on matters of race. In any case, Leo's father wanted this friendship, and we can only guess and imagine why. But Leo owes nothing to this man. It is entirely Leo's choice to decide whether or not to befriend his father's friend. Perhaps Leo could educate this man, or even learn more about his own father from this person. And this friend obviously wanted a friendship with Leo's father. Since the friends spent many years together, the two men must have shared something which was beneficial to both of them. In the end, it is entirely up to Leo as to what he does, if anything, regarding making a connection with this man. Whatever he decides to do, we wish Leo a wonderful, full life. Today's quote is, "A racist thought and action says far more about the person they come from than the person they are directed at," by Chris Crutcher. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed listening to Leo's story today. So perhaps you may have a comment, opinion, question, or answer to Leo's story. If so, we would like to hear from you. And you can read other people's comments and opinions below relating to this letter. And remember that by liking and subscribing to this channel, you will hear me read letters every week on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, which people send us about issues they are dealing with in their lives. These are real-life personal stories and people's everyday experiences. And don't forget, if you have a personal story or issue which you would like to share with us, please send us an email using the email provided in the description box below. We would be very happy to hear from you. We thank you for joining us here today, where life happens. See you next time, and have a wonderful day.